in order to find your voice, if you want to bypass the years of experience, because that's ultimately what it is, right? When you find your voice, ultimately what you're doing is you're finding your confidence. And you know, you hear this saying that in order to find your confidence, it's all in repetition, it's all in practice. But what if you're new and you're a little anxious, right? Like, we're kind of wired to have things instantaneously now. And so if you don't want to go through 5, 15, 25 years of experience, you don't want to do your 10,000 hours of work to become a professional or a master of your craft, what do you do? Well, what you do is you find someone who's already put in the 10,000 hours, someone who's already at the level that you want to be, who's already attaining the success and actually experiencing the lifestyle that you want to have. And ultimately what you do is you become influenced by them. But does this mean that you have to ask them to be your mentor? Does this mean that you have to, you know, stalk them and, you know, ask them for piggyback rides and hang out with them all day, buy them lunch and be their slave? No, it does not. What you do have to do though is be creative. And so you have to find your way to put yourself within that surrounding, whether you go to the same lunch places or you hang out in the same area during lunchtime, or whether you ask to be moved closer towards where they are in that office so you can really absorb their work ethic. You can hear what they say. One thing that I did when I first came in, I found out who the alpha male was. I found out who the top producers were. And something that you do when you're new is you shadow, right? But it blows my mind, because if you don't shadow correctly, what the hell are you doing? You're just watching them, you're watching a one-sided conversation. You know what I mean? You don't hear the other person talk, and they're moving around some CRM that you've never seen in your life, asking questions that you have no idea the hell you're supposed to do with it. And so the best way to really shadow someone is find out who you're shadowing. Find out who the top producer is. Don't just shadow anybody. Don't shadow just anyone because they're experienced. Ask first. Say, hey man, who's the top producers? Who's the heavy hitters? I want to shadow that dude or that chick. And when you do shadow them, I want you to discreetly turn on your recorder, your voice recorder on your phone. And I want you to record that experience, because what you're doing is you're hearing their go-to. You're hearing their lingo, their rhythm, their vibe, right? And so ultimately what you're doing is now you don't necessarily need to listen to every single word. You're just seeing how they compose themselves, how they carry themselves. You know, you're studying kind of the way their desk is laid out. You're studying their management, their time management skills, their process, their flow, their system. Because that system is what's generating that person's money. That system has been developed over years of repetition, over years of practice. And so it's kind of like you getting that cheat code, that up, up, down, down, left, right, you remember that? Anyway, you're actually getting a sneak peek of something that's taken years upon years and hours upon hours to manufacture. And so you're ultimately just kind of really adapting that. Now, you can go back later on and listen to the voice, listen to the tone, listen to the script, the lingo, and you can use your creativity to put two and two together. But keep in mind that that's the default mode of that top producer. And so that default mode is just something that it took a while to progress. And the challenge with you being new or coming into an industry brand new is you don't know what to do. You don't want to make the wrong move. You don't want to, you know, sound stupid. Then don't. Sound just like the top closer in the room. Do exactly what the top closer in the room's doing. You know what I mean? Say the exact words that work because the top producers work in it, and you know it works because you see them consistently winning the awards or getting recognized for being a top producer. So if it works for them, don't reinvent the wheel, boo-boo. Don't try to fix something that's not broke. Really, for real, you have to really understand that in order to find your identity, it does take confidence, it does take repetition, but at the root of it all, what it does take is execution. You just gotta go. You just gotta start, right? Don't be afraid of failure. Don't be afraid of what everyone else thinks, because to be honest with you, no one cares. No one gives a fuck about what you're doing. They don't care about whether you mess up or not. Only you do. And the faster that you can really kind of take these philosophies and ideologies and lessons and shares and tidbits that I give at Sales Remastered and really internalize them, the faster you're going to be able to fly on your own, the faster you're going to be able to find your confidence, and the faster you're going to be able to find your voice.